Good evening. Welcome to this year's Young Musician Competition. There are some fantastic finalists playing to you tonight, and I hope you really enjoy their performances. We are fortunate enough to have Alasdair Jamieson adjudicate this year. Alasdair has been a lecturer at Durham University, a lay clerk at Ripon Cathedral, and directors of music at Bootham School, Chiltern Junior School, and St Helens and St Catherine's. Thank you very much, Alasdair, for adjudicating today. And without further ado, let us move on to the performances. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. j'aime ton front. Oh, ma rebelle, oh, ma farouche, j'aime tes yeux, j'aime ta bouche, et mes baisers épuiseront. Ta voix, j'aime l'étrange grâce de tout ce que tu dis. Oh, ma rebelle, oh, mon cher ange, mon enfer et mon paradis. J'aime tes yeux, j'aime ton front. Farouche, j'aime tes yeux, j'aime ta bouche, et mes baisers épuiseront. J'aime tu. Ce qui te fait belle de tes pieds jusqu'à tes cheveux. Oh, toi avec qui monte mes voeux. Oh, ma farouche, oh, ma rebelle. J'aime tes yeux, j'aime ton front. Oh, ma rebelle, oh, ma farouche, j'aime tes yeux, j'aime ta biche, et mes baisers épuiseront, et mes baisers épuiseront.
God become in this year. Sit a rose, sit on a lane. This is a twale son tis you. We did twale. Twist the leaves.
Thank you to all those of you who performed just then. It was absolutely fantastic. I'd now like to hand over to Alasdair, who will give his feedback and adjudications. Thank you, Alasdair.
Well, thank you for inviting me this evening. And I must say, I've had a very pleasant time listening to these performances, which are of a very high standard indeed. And do both yourselves and your teachers and mentors very great credit. The standard, as I say, is very, very high. I also like the fact that you all know how to present yourself on stage. You come on at the end, you smile and you bow, acknowledging the audience's applause. And that may seem unimportant, but it's not. Stage etiquette is actually rather central in some ways. It affects how you feel about what you're doing as well. I'm going to just make some comments about every player this evening and every singer, and then pick a runner-up and a winner. But before I do that, I think perhaps we all ought to be thankful for the stalwart playing of James Winkley, who's given you wonderful support throughout the evening with some rather tricky accompaniments, it must be said. So thank you very much, James. And so onwards. We started with Ella playing the Allegro Brillante, and I thought you had a good, competent bowing technique. This was committed playing of a high order with growing evidence of romantic interpretation as the piece proceeded, particularly actually in the more lyrical second theme. There were obviously just the odd momentary tuning issues and a few rhythmic infelicities, but these were as nothing in the context of the sweep of your playing and the very pleasing tone you summoned from your instrument. So well done indeed. We then had Sophie playing Remembrances by John Williams. And I thought this was a secure and convincing performance that just needed perhaps a little more emotional involvement to make the cantilena, the sort of singing line, actually sing out. Keep listening, obviously, at all times to your tuning. The cadenza-like passage towards the end was especially well handled. I thought this was most promising, and with a well-defined bowing action again, and also, you know, technical proficiency. We then had Calum playing the Introduction and Tarantella by Sarasati. You had a nice sense of rubato, which is the sort of stealing of, literally the stealing of time, slowing up and then balancing it by pushing on. And you combine this with an emphasis on the important notes at the start. So this was a very good beginning indeed. You immediately created exactly the right atmosphere. The tarantella settled into an exciting dance. You met the technical demands of this piece, which are considerable. They're calling as they do for harmonics and double stopping and left-hand pizzicato, among other things. That was very good. Do listen again to the tuning when you get higher into the stratosphere, and perhaps take more care over the transition passages where one figuration gives way to another. Those are the bits that actually may not seem telling, but they are, in fact. All in all, I thought this was an exciting take on the Sarasati, and one which bodes well for the future. You play with quite a bit of flair. And then Anna played the first of the five bagatelles by Finzi. I thought this gained in confidence as it went on. The slower central section and the recapitulation were respectively both sensitive and then exciting. And you had a particularly exciting and convincing ending. Try to perhaps replicate the warm sound you get in the shallow register, the low register, throughout the instrument's range by just modulating your lip pressure a little more. There were some momentary rhythmic unsteadiness at the start, but I thought you settled into this performance well. You're a promising player. Then we had Ichao playing the guitar, and I thought you created an attractive atmosphere. It made us think of warmer climes. I mean, I'm speaking from Yorkshire, where springtime is not going to come probably until the middle of June, you know, and warmer emotions as well. The melody was well brought out above the bass and middle registers. I think now you just need to concentrate on those rapid arabesques and just get them completely under control, and this will make it outstanding. The minor slips mattered little, as your overall control of the ambience was very convincing. So thank you for your sensitive playing. And then we had Jamie singing Chanson d'amour by Gabriel Fauré. You've got a good, clear, true voice, Jamie. I liked your attempt to interpret the words. I think just be careful what you do with your hands. You probably don't need to move them quite as much. What you do with your voice is certainly along the right lines, and you brought out the yearning quality of the melody by discrete emphasis of particular notes. The French language is really tricky to sing in, but I thought you prepared well and the elusive vowel sounds of that language were coming along nicely. I enjoyed this, and I would encourage you to take it much further in your future studies. Tom then sang Nuit d'Etoile by Debussy. You filled on with confidence. You made good eye contact with the audience. In other words, you communicated well. Just make sure you keep the intensity of your performance going when you're not singing, when the piano is playing an interlude. Don't sort of drift off. You didn't, but you know, there was just a feeling of a little moment of lacuna, of intensity there. Just occasionally, I think you can project your sound a little more. Your words, having said that, are actually very clear indeed. Again, perhaps do slightly less with your hands. Keep them down by your sides or just in front with you. I thought you had a very promising voice and you delivered the song with charm and sensitivity. It was most encouraging. So do keep it up, keep it going. Harrison played the canzonetta from Tchaikovsky's violin concerto. You have a lovely rich tone at the start of this concerto movement. I thought it was really quite something. Just make sure you sustain that sort of richness, if you can, throughout the whole piece. Your trills and ornaments were very well managed. You looked fully involved with the musical utterance. Again, as I've said before, just be careful, particularly careful with the tuning of those sort of little notes, the ones that appear to be unimportant, but are actually, they do actually make all the difference, that occur within the melodic contour. I liked what you were trying to do with this piece. You managed to convey your affection for it to the audience. Izzy then played another concerto movement. This is the slow movement from Elgar's cello concerto. You have a really rich, sustained tone, and this is achieved by judicious use of vibrato. Very good indeed. One thing, I think this movement needs a lot of space, and you gave it a lot of space, but I think at the end of phrases, just take care shaping off the end of a phrase before you go on to the next one. And there was a feeling just occasionally you were jumping on to the next phrase without really seeing out the previous one. It was most impressive changing of the hand position up and down the fingerboards, just the occasional laps, but nothing serious at all. And I think you made your instrument sing out in an affecting and effective way. This was a mature and satisfying interpretation. So very well done. Then we had two flautists. Olivia played, first of all, a very attractive piece by James Ray. This was agile, confident, as well as being well sustained when the music demanded it. A cheeky ending as well, which is delightful. You have an assured technique and a good tone. Just occasionally, the runs were slightly skated over. But as a whole, I thought this was really mature and impressive music making of a very high quality. I enjoyed it very much. And then Poppy playing the Forêt Fantasy. I thought you settled into this piece and both your tone and your phrasing developed nicely. Perhaps try to incorporate a wider range of dynamics into the slow lyrical playing. However, when we got to the fast bit, that was really quite something. You had nimble tonguing, the scales and the arpeggios were impressive. It was dexterous stuff. You project your tone very well and managed to involve us, the audience, in your interpretation. Well done indeed. And finally, Alice, who sang Think of Me from Phantom of the Opera. You have a lovely clear voice, Alice, ideally suited to this music. Your words are crystal clear. You have the confidence to appear relaxed and dramatically involved in the sense of the words. The cadenza was very well managed with an impressive top C at the end. It must be said, and Dr. Winkley will know about this, that Andrew Lloyd Webber is not really my favorite composer, but I thought you made an excellent job of convincing me of his worth. So very well done. You should take it further, seriously. So to get a runner-up, or perhaps two runners-up, and a winner, I find it very difficult to choose between the two flautists, Olivia and Poppy. And so I'd like to give them joint runner-up positions. And the winner, I think, this evening of the performance I enjoyed most was Alice singing Think of Me just at the end there, Andrew Lloyd Webber. So congratulations to the winner, to the runners-up, and indeed to everyone who has played and sung this evening. Thank you very much. I've enjoyed it.
Well, thank you very much for that, Alasdair. Certainly a worthy winner indeed. And thank you everyone else for watching this tonight. Good evening.